There doesn't need to be anything to prevent liberation. This is liberation. Yes.
This is wholeness. Already, all there is wholeness. Already, this is wholeness, including that which she is holding.
Yes. You see, there is great energy here, and it's like a spaceship goes on. So, what do you mean of this? It's all in the dream world. It's all a dream. Is it more precious, the energy? And another thing, I have heard you saying something, or I was reading something when you mentioned a shift of perception, a shift, and I wondered what you meant with it.
No, there can be an apparently contracted energy, which can apparently dispel into the boundless, melt into the boundless, apparently. But when suddenly that happens, or when it appears to happen, there's a realization that actually nothing is happening. There is no such thing as contracted energy, sinking, separation, liberation. All there is this.
This apparent happening is a great gift anyway.
It's not a gift to anybody. It's not
for anyone.
It's a curse.
Yes.
For the individual, it's a curse. It's death. No, there's nothing that gains from it, because there is no value to it.
Thank you.
It's only the individual that believes in values and thinks certain things are valuable than others are. That's the truth. Everything is simply what it is.
And then something to this word perception. There is an expression, seeing what is.
Oh, okay, so that doesn't apply.
Not to nothing. It's not your terminology.
If it was saying what is, there would be something from it saying what is. It's only what is.
It's like, you know, one to the next teacher is always putting something in a way right, or to this new way of terminology of understanding. It's like when you go to a therapist, later on you go to another therapist, and the next one he used the old one, you know?
Okay, so here there's only destruction.
Thank you.
You talk like Chris about that feeling of when there is nobody, everything appears like nothing appears in everything. And about 1 year ago, I had this experience for about 2 weeks. And it was like, the experience was like coming 100% into being there. I can understand.
Yeah.
And now, since some weeks, it's this terrible feeling of disappearing. But this time it's not nice at all anymore. It is like getting crazy, and it's like something like I disappear, and it's even more the feeling of being enclosed in something like the me or the I or something like this. And it's like getting like in a dream. Or like looking into the mirror, I know that I'm not this one in the mirror. It's just like this, and it's a little bit of feeling like this.
Yeah.
I feel this unreal, this unreality. I feel very, very much, very much. I feel this. The very many times I feel very much unreal, and it makes me really. And, I'm really not, I don't really even know if some, like, identity just loosens a little bit, or if I get crazy.
There are many things happen, obviously, awakening seems to happen, and thereafter there's all sorts of different things that seem to happen to some people and not others.
Mm-hmm.
So it can seem chaotic.
after awakening, and all sorts of psychological things might come up to be fall away, or all sorts of strange things seem to happen. And for some people, not others. And there's nothing, there's no explanation for it. There's nothing obviously that can be done with it all. It's what's happening. They say that was a very emotional comment. I felt a lot of fears in that.
That makes it very important. Somehow that adds us up. Is it somehow as though feelings mean, you know, aliveness or something? It's become another religion.
To me, it seems like sometimes these feelings are strongly just felt as feelings and not going, there's no one going into a story sometimes, you know.
They can be so powerful, like anything else. You know, this individual energy is so insubstantial, but there are things that can happen when it just falls away, like the great feelings can arise and a feeling can overtake, and there's no one in there. It just is the feeling.
It could
just be anger, and there's no one in there. Or in other ways, you know, in making love, or paintings, or running, all sorts of things which are so, can just become themselves on their own with no one in them.
Disappearing in it?
Well, they don't disappear, they just never.
There's no one
there
from the start. And there's no
feelings, or things can be so powerful that they are all there is there. Mm-hmm. There's no longer a sense of there being there.
But that would be an experience.
Well,
if there is someone who still believes that there is
someone. No, there doesn't have to be any sense. But that doesn't mean then that suddenly there's liberation. There's many times in a person's day or year when there is no one, especially in DBC.
Or when one is not communicating just by oneself.
Well, I don't know about that. Mm-hmm. I'm just saying there are often times in an apparent individual's day when there is no sense of anything.
Mm-hmm.
It just isn't. It's no more than that. Mm-hmm. It's just like a blank.
Mm-hmm. And there is. Just wondered if one could be partly only the feelings and partly having a tendency to be almost like divided, the schizophrenic, you know. On one side there is the strong feeling and no one there, but then again, I don't know.
Well, it varies. I mean, most of the time people think they have feelings, but they know the feeling. It's happening to me. But there can be sometimes when it's so powerful that there's no one, but then it's just the
feeling. No one at all, yeah. So can it go forward and backwards? Can it go
forward? Of course it does. Mm-hmm. Because the whole energy of the contracted sense of self is completely fractious. It comes and goes. It's not fixed.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Well, I don't think there's anything that's ridiculous or not ridiculous. So, what do you mean by ridiculous?
It's difficult for me to explain. It's just that when I hear you speaking the word, when I hear you talking the word ridiculous in all the videos I saw, it's just that I'm laughing about everything in such a way so that I question myself, is there anything not like this?
Well, this message sort of turns over the tables as far as the individual story is concerned, and you could then say that it then reveals it as being ridiculous, but in a way that judges something that is simply an appearance. You know, there's nothing right or wrong. There's no
there's nothing that's better or worse, it just is what there is. In that sense, I couldn't call the individual dream ridiculous. It just is nothing appearing as an individual dream. Somebody else called it madness, in the way you could say it's madness. It's what's happening. And for the individual, it seems very safe and understandable.
There are feelings or thoughts that arise, which I normally think that are very serious, and I think of you, so it's all ridiculous. It's just in a sense helpful for me to see it in that sense.
Oh, I see. Yeah. That's only another sort of method, really, or it's just another trick.
only so-called or apparent individual seer, there is no seeing, because you say being doesn't see, being is not seeing itself. There's only individual apparent seeing. And would that be the so-called eye of God? Would be individual apparent seeing.
Something about God or something?
The eye of God.
Oh God, no, there's no God. There definitely is not a God.
There's no levels.
There's not, no, there isn't something else. There's nothing else like this. This is all there is. There's nothing apart.
And this is seen by no one.
There isn't anyone to see it.
How can we give it names and call it? And
well, you can't give it names. There's an attempt to try and describe it. It can't be named. It can't be described because it can't be known. What we long for is unknowing.
What we're longing for
is unknowing. And the problem with the seeker is that the seeker tries to know unknown.
Yeah, it's lovely.
It's
difficult.
And there is no starting and no end.
No, there's no starting and no end.
And it's no process.
No,
it's
there's no in or out or under or below.
And nothing doesn't play a role.
Nothing that would.
Nothing is playing a role. There's no role.
There is only in the appearance. There seems to be something playing a role.
Yes. It's blasphemy, is it? Blasphemous.
There is no, well, blasphemy is, I think, is taking a God's name in vain. I don't know. Maybe it's, there appears to be blasphemy.
Yeah.
But there appears to be none.
Not to mention Marmite.
It's nothing appearing as this. And nothing appearing as God, too.
Yes. I just wonder if there is any on this path, this so-called pathway, this process pass to come to this to not arrive in this always arriving and never arrive
A path is about never arriving, because there is no path.
If there is any intake of blocks, any result, if that's any
result. No, there's no result.
No? It's not a result. It has always been like that. And
Well, it hasn't always been like that. It already is that.
Yes. It has always been already that.
Well, if you like. The seeker, by already being.
At least someone's poetry.
Thank you.
If you see God as unconditioned love, then there is God.
It's just another name.
It's just words.
Yeah.
It's all words. But when we're talking about it, it is absolutely beyond words. It can't be discussed. It's about something that's utterly, completely simple and obvious. And for the seeker can't see that because the seeker is looking for it. The seeker, in a sense, is looking for a treasure in life. And life is the treasure. Thank you.